Hello everyone and assalamu alaikum and welcome back to our channel Zara Top Keys. So yes guys, hope you're all doing good and staying safe. So we have uploaded a Meto style mutton biryani which is very yummy. Initially we have uploaded it, do check it out. So this time we are presenting a very quite simple elegant biryani. This is like we don't have to sort anything, we just have to cook. So let's see the recipe, let's move on to the recipe. Before that, if you start loving watching our videos or if you find our videos useful, please do like, share and subscribe our channel. So yes, also hit the bell icon next to the subscribe channel so that any notifications from our end will be updated to you soon. So stay tuned, let's move on to the recipe. Biryani recipe, just 3 main steps: marination, rice preparation and mixing. So first let us see marination part. For that I have taken 750 grams of chicken, big cut pieces, 1 teaspoon of salt, then goes 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, then 3 teaspoons of biryani masala. Here I have taken Lulu biryani masala which was available with me. So you can take any of your kind of your choice which is available at your home. 3 teaspoons will do. And then 1/2 cup of yogurt, 2 to 3 tablespoons of yogurt, and 1/2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste. Handful of coriander leaves, 3 to 4 tablespoons will do. Handful of coriander leaves and mint leaves. More the mint leaves added, the greater taste it will be. And then 2 to 3 green chilies plus fried onions, 2 to 3 tablespoons of fried onions. That's it. So here we are going to mix it or combine it very nicely. I am using my hands itself. You can combine with your hands very nicely. And we are going to rest it till we prepare rice. So once the rice is prepared, we will be combining this marination plus rice. So let's move on to the rice preparation now. Before that we have to close the lid and keep aside. Let it rest for further 10 to 15 minutes. Meanwhile we can prepare rice. Second step is rice preparation. For that here I have taken 3 glasses of rice, that is 3 cups of rice. Here I have taken basmati rice. You can take any brand of your choice and then keep water to boil. For 3 cups I have taken 6 cups of water. Keep on boil and within that you can add raw spices. Here it goes, 3 to 4 cardamoms, 1 bay leaf, 1 big cinnamon stick in 2 pieces you can add. Add enough amount of salt which is required to cook rice, and we have to add little bit more because we have added water to it. And now once water is boiled, add the soaked rice or cleaned rice and then give a good mix. So let it boil for further. When it comes to a high boil, close the lid, lower the flame and keep a lid over it. So it just still take 5 to 10 minutes to cook. It should be 75% of total cook. It should not very cook. it should be just 3/4 of the cookness required, because we are going to mix the rice and chicken and then we are going to cook further. Once rice is cooked, remove from the flame and keep aside. Now we are going to cook the chicken and rice. We are going to combine in it. For that, what we are going to do is keep a vessel. Once heated, add 2 tablespoons of oil and 2 tablespoons of ghee. Or you can do the other part too. You can change the proportionality of ghee and oil. Add both oil and ghee. After that, we are going to transfer all the chicken marinated chicken to this vessel. So it should be in low flame now. Transfer all the marinated chicken pieces to this vessel with oil and ghee. We are keeping it in low flame and we are going to cook this chicken pieces with the rice on top of it. So slowly add these pieces. We have to spread these pieces in the vessel evenly, otherwise it won't cook nicely, because if we have dumped it here like this, it won't cook evenly and nicely, because in the middle of the vessel it will be a very high flame, high heat will be coming out. So it just have a tendency to stick to the bottom. So just spread evenly to all the sides, all the corners of the sides of the vessel, and then just cause 1 medium sized tomatoes, finely chopped tomatoes. Here I have taken 1. Then give a good mix. Let it cook for 2 to 3 minutes and then take our rice and spread the rice onto this chicken pieces very evenly. Just layer it out. So you can, layering should be like, you can give 1 layer of rice on top of the chicken and then you can garnish with coriander leaves, mint leaves and then fried onions or ghee and ghee, and then give the other layer on top of this garnish, or you can transfer all the rice and on top of that we can garnish here. So it just require 1 layering. If we garnish on top of whole rice, so here it's like after adding rice, I'm going to add fried onions and then coriander leaves, mint leaves and garam masala or biryani masala, whichever we have. Just give 1 teaspoon of biryani masala, spread it evenly on top of rice. Either you can layer twice or you can layer once, not a problem. If it is a small quantity like 3 cups of rice, you can layer it once, that will do. So just, it is according to your preference, you can do this one. So after adding rice, I am going to layer it with 1 to 2 teaspoons of chicken masala or biryani masala. Just pour it over and then add coriander leaves, mint leaves, handful of this will do, plus fried onions 2 to 3 tablespoons, spread evenly, and ghee you can put in all sides, you can just drop or drizzle some ghee on top of it. Why we are adding ghee is like it won't stick, the rice won't stick to each other if we add ghee. It is a good one, it is good to add ghee. So that's it guys. Thank you. as I said earlier, it should be in low flame and close the lid once layered and keep a very good weight over top of it. Here I have taken uduli and kept it there. And now on top of that, you can keep in a small vessel 2 tablespoons of milk, plain warm milk plus saffron immersed in. So you can keep that small ball on top of this biryani so that this saffron will nicely mix with this milk and it will get a yellow colored milk like this. We are going to garnish it in the biryani. So we can add this plain saffron milk so that it just gets an yellow colored texture, so that we don't need to go to the artificial colors. We will not end up with artificial colors. This is a good option. Just try it out and let me know your valuable comments. Ensure to keep it on low flame and cook or dum. We have kept a weight over it. With the weight, we are cooking it in dum, and then it will take just around 10 to 15 minutes. After that, you can switch off the flame and then keep on cooking, keep on having dum for further 10 to 15 minutes without flame. So it will be like everything will be blended in. Now it's ready. Our biryani, simple biryani, is ready. Now it's time to serve. So while mixing, we have to do it very gently, otherwise everything will get into a mess. So you can see here, we have to take it from the bottom while serving, because we are having our masalas at the bottom, right? So we have to mix this and then give. So yes guys, our delicious chicken biryani, which is very simple, is ready and we are going to serve it. So guys, do try this recipe at your end. It is very easy, very very easy. You just need marination and rice preparation. Just do it and give a try. And let me know your valuable comments. You can type it in the comment box. Also, if you are watching our channel for the first time, or if you haven't subscribed our channel, please do like, share and subscribe. Alhamdulillah, that was a good treat. And thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you liked it. So yes guys, inshallah we shall be back with a new vlog soon. So stay tuned. This is me, Farzana, signing off. Assalamu alaikum.